Hi, I'm Zach.
And I'm Karen. Welcome to the very first episode of the Control Cabinet Classroom.
Here at Phoenix Contact, we want to make life a little easier by breaking down some of the basics of control cabinet design technologies.
Today, we're going to explore the concept of power reliability. So what do we mean exactly by power reliability, and why does it matter? Well, we're here to tell you.
Clean, reliable power serves as the heartbeat of every industrial control cabinet. Because it's so important, design engineers must consider many application-specific factors and use tried-and-true best practices when designing their power circuits.
Most of these best practices will fall into one of four categories: protection, conversion, distribution, and monitoring. Oh, and here's a cool graphic so you can visualize those concepts.
First, let's talk about surge protection, because every control cabinet needs protection.
Absolutely. You need to protect the control cabinet from overcurrents or voltage transients.
Ooh, big words.
Yeah. Anyway, while they might be big words, they're actually simple concepts. In reality, transients and overcurrent events occur all the time, and they can originate on the incoming power line or from things happening in the field, like short circuits, for example. Also, these transients and overcurrent events can become so large that they can damage or even destroy devices in the power circuit, which obviously isn't good.
To illustrate this concept, let's imagine this electric dog collar is a field device that has a short, and my vocal cords are the sensitive components in your panel. Normally, this device would produce a current that, while unpleasant, would not cause any damage to my throat. But because it has a short, there is now an unintentional path for current to flow to something that was never meant to see that much current, creating an overcurrent event.
That's right, Zach. And while I would have loved to have done a live demo of that concept today, someone said it wouldn't be a really good idea to shock Zach. So that's a bummer.
Maybe next time.
But what we'd really like you to take away from this is that although transients and overcurrent events happen all the time, the good news is that there are protective devices you can employ, like fuses, circuit breakers, and surge arresters, that will ensure your panel is protected. These protective devices are some of the building blocks of clean and reliable power, aka power reliability. So how many volts have you been hit with over the years, Zach?
Too many to count, but if you tune into some of our next videos, you'll see me get shocked again, I guarantee it. Next, let's talk about power conversion. The role is to take incoming power, often 120 volts AC in the United States, and then convert it to a lower, safer voltage in the control panel. More often than not, that voltage is 24 volts DC, which is commonly sourced from a power supply, like this one. It's important to note that conversion is not only confined to power supplies. You also find supporting products like battery backup systems, UPSs, and redundancy modules.
Moving on to the next category within power reliability, we have monitoring. Specifically, we're talking about measuring and tracking voltage, current, and power values within your cabinet or system. This is important because by tracking these values, you can assess the overall health of your system to determine how efficiently it's functioning and do predictive maintenance, which optimizes system reliability and uptime. This, in turn, saves companies money and makes shareholders really, really happy.
Yeah, so for example, by monitoring the current draw of a motor, a user could, over time, see that draw become higher. This higher current could be a result of a bearing within the motor getting old and needing replacement. If you replace those bearings before they fail and completely destroy your motor, you'll save a lot of time and a lot of money and prevent massive headaches.
Right, so to wrap it up, within the category of monitoring, you'll find products like energy meters, transducers, current transformers, and electronic circuit breakers, like these.
Finally, we have power distribution. When we talk about distribution, we're typically talking about two different things. First, distributing that safe 24 volts DC from the power supply to the rest of the control cabinet or out into the devices in the field. Second, passing the higher voltage, typically 120 volts AC, from the control cabinet out to field devices operating on that voltage. Regardless of whether it's 24 or 120 volts or some other voltage, the products we tend to associate with distribution are terminal blocks and power supplies.
In summary, power reliability can be broken down into four categories: protection, conversion, distribution, and monitoring. If you're interested in learning more about these topics, please check out all the videos in our power reliability section on our YouTube page. Also, if you like this video, please give us a big old thumbs up and be sure to subscribe so you get all our new videos as they're released. See you next time.